In this video, we want to create a more complex object, say an arm with a hand and a finger, and an old part should be movable in a simple way. So we start, a finger has two parts. One is this finger, and this is the fingertip. So, and we make a compound of these two objects. Create a compound. This also can be a fusion, but in Animation Workbench, I prefer compound. It's easier to use and it's faster to recompute. Okay, and we call it, this is the compound finger. And the placer finger, we say that target is the compound finger, and we have a rotation as known in this way. Say we only have 180 degrees. This is enough, so let's test it. Works fine. So the next is I create a compound of this one and say create a compound, and now I call this one, this is the animated finger. So it's useful to go this way, we will see why. The next one we hide it, and we say we make a copy of the button, and we call this one, this is the hand. So, and now we put the comp and the same as with the torus. We say this is also hand connector to finger. So, and we have here this one, and we move it to this position. Okay, and now we say these three parts, the compound animated finger, the hand, and the hand connector should build a new compound, and this we call compound hand. And we make a placer for the compound hand and say nothing, and here we say the target is the compound hand. Okay, and rotation axis should be the same, so we can test this, and we also can now rotate the finger. So in this moment I have to hide the underlying components. I only need the compound hand. I see at the moment there is a problem. I have the compound finger inside the compound hand. This is too much. I only need the compound animated finger. So I delete the compound finger from the compound hand. And now I have the hand. And here I have the movement of the finger. For a fine adjustment, I have to do some special work to get here the right point of rotation, but it's not a principal problem. So, okay, I close them, and now the same procedure from the compound hand. I create a new compound and I call this compound animated hand. Okay, and we have to set both positions back to zero. So now the next what we do is we again make copies of the torus and the bottom, and we call this is the arm, and this is the arm connector to hand. So, and we move this hand and arm to this position. So now this is the hand, this is the finger, and this is the arm. And we build a compound of all of these three ones, compound, create a compound. So, and we can add the next placer for the arm. And we say here the same, but in this case we use another rotation axis. We do not use the z-axis, but we use, say, the y-axis to see a difference. And okay, we have to add the target. The target is compound 4. This is the compound arm. So, and now we see we can do this animation. We can change the finger, and we can move the hand. So we see we have here a movement in along the z-axis, and here's the same, and the arm rotates along the y-axis. Here still from top, the hand, the finger, and the arm goes up and down. So in this way we can build cascaded animations. Let's see the dependency graph. Okay, we have here the finger, the compound finger, and the finger has its placer. Then we have as next a compound which has the function to create a hull around this animation. Then three component, the next compound, the compound hand, here's the placer of the hand. Then once again a compound around this. Then next these two objects, these three objects, the compound of the hand and the arm and the connector, the next compound, and one more placer here. And so we have the hierarchy of the placers. The detail placer, the middle placer, and the global placer, and the other objects are still here in our file.